In this movie, we'll present how we suggest to model zones for energy model analysis in ArchiCAD. We have to create a zone in every conditioned space of the building, using either the manual or the inner edge zone construction method. The zones must be adjoining the surrounding element surfaces. When placing zones on the floor plan, make sure that they're completely enclosed by zone boundaries. Walls and profiled curtain walls automatically behave as zone boundaries. When using slabs as bottom or top zone boundaries, make sure that the zone level or height are set so that the horizontal zone surface touches the inner edge of the slab. If roofs, meshes, shells, or ArchiCAD library objects are used as zone boundaries, it's recommended to use the Trim Elements or Solid Element Operations command to shape the zone with the selected zone boundaries to establish the connection between them. If it's necessary, you can define the lines as zone boundaries as well. We've used this solution to separate the kitchen, hall, and living room spaces. Always use separate zones on every different story of your project. The living room space is two story heights. It has a gallery on the second floor, but we shouldn't model it with one zone. For accurate energy evaluation, we modeled the airspace with a separate zone stamp on the related level. This zone starts from the top of the living room and hits the bottom of the flat roof.